good morning, students. So today I will discuss what is the seed and seedling vigor. So seed is not new to you, because it may be in inter-level or graduation level you might have studied about seeds, or I think you have studied something about seed. So what is seed? So we see in detail. So seed is nothing but it is the fertilized ovule, ripened ovule after fertilization by the pollen and some growth within the mother plant. An embryo develops from zygote, that is called fertilized ovum, and seed coat develops from the integuments of the ovule. So two things are there: embryo that will develop from the zygote, and seed coat that it develops from the integuments of the ovule. So seed, generally if you see the seeds, or you might have seen the seeds, different seeds. So again, there is difference between seed and grains. So grains you can use for the consumption purpose, seeds we can use for the sowing purpose. So if you see the seed, so seed has some protective layering, so maybe protective layer, maybe seed coat. Okay, so we'll see in detail. And how seed production will take place. So if you see, so there are two types of seed. First is enclosed seed, and enclosed seed is produced in angiosperm. So angiosperm, you can see it produced in the hard or fleshy structure, that is called fruits. And some fruits have layer of both hard and fleshy material. So see the difference. In angiosperm, your seeds are enclosed. But see the next slide. In case of gymnosperm, your seeds are naked. So no special structure develops to enclose the seeds. So begin their development on the blades of the cones. So here cones are available. You can see the figure. And seeds do become covered by the cones scales in some species of the conifers. So this is the difference between seeds of gymnosperm and angiosperm. Now if you see the seed structure, so you have see, this is the embryo, then we have fertilized ovule and immature plant from which new plant will grow under proper condition. Again you have monocot seed, and again you have dicot seeds. So now you see the difference in that. So you can see here, so monocot seeds and dicot seeds. So you know what is the difference between monocot and dicot. So just see the diagram and we'll see the difference in the next slide. So if you see the diagram, like you can see, in case of monocot, just you have given example of corn, that is called maize. In case of dicotyledon, you have given example of bean. So you can see here, roots are fibrous. Here, roots are taproot. You can see here, venations are parallel. But here, see, venations may be net-like veins. Okay, here you will find only one cotyledon. Here you will find two cotyledon. So here, given the difference, you can see comparison between the monocot and dicot plant. So seeds, single cotyledon, then two cotyledon. Leaves, you can see parallel veins and branched veins. So students often confused. I have seen that students often confused ki how to identify monocot plants and dicot plants. But these are the certain criteria, certain properties are there. So based on that, you can easily identify the monocot and dicot plants. So see, so seeds, because cotyledons they are inside, so you cannot see. But leaves, so leaves are very very important to identify the plants, whether it plants are monocot or dicot. So if you see the leaves, so in case of monocot, you will find parallel venation. You can see parallel venation. But in case of dicot, you will see branch veins. Again, you will see the flower. So floral flowers often in multiples of three. You can see here, multiples of three. But in case of dicotyledon, floral parts often in multiples of four or five. So again, this is the difference. Based on flower, you can distinguish what is the monocot plant and what is the dicot plant. Now if you see the stems, so again, you know, vascular bundles scatter throughout the stem. But if you see the vascular bundles of dicot plant, vascular bundles are arranged in a ring. So again, you cannot identify based on the morphology, you have to cut the sections. So finally, you have to see the leaves and flowers. Again, roots. So just I told you, in case of monocot, roots are fibrous roots. But in case of dicot, roots are tap roots. So again, you have to pull out. Unless you pull out the roots, you cannot see the difference. So I always advise students to go for leaves and flowers. If leaves are available, based on the leaves also you can distinguish what is the monocot and what is the digot plants. Even if flowers are available, then you have two different parameters by which we can distinguish the monocot and digot plants. Now seed structure. So seed coat develop from the maternal tissue, and just I told you it helps protect the embryo, because seed coat is hard, so it just protect the embryo. Any mature seed can be paper thin layer, that is called, you can see example like peanut, very fine thin layer. But sometimes, you know, more substantial, if you see the coconut, very hard. And third is fleshy, as in charcoal test of the pomegranate. So these different criteria, what you call aspects are there, maybe thin layer, maybe more substantial, maybe hard seed. And now we see seedling vigor. So again, vigor means how seeds are germinating very fast. So it determines the potential level of activity and performance of the seed or seed load during germination and seedling emergence. So if you have sown the seed, so you have to see how fast seeds are going to germinate. So that is your seedling emergence or germination. That is called vigor, means how fast they are going to germinate the seeds. So seedling vigor test, after 1 month, you can see based on the shoot die length, die weight, then root weight for seedling vigor calculation, then seedling height, leaf expansion rate, relative growth rate, and vigor scores to evaluate seedling vigor. So these are certain parameters. Based on parameters, you can tell that this particular seed has high vigor as compared to the next one. So these are the factors affecting the seed vigor. So maybe harvesting, so just after physiological maturity, then handling, then finally storing seed to the minimize damage. So these are the parameters. Thank you.